In the 1920s, the US stock exchange experienced a period of growth previously unknown. Everyone speculated, and many became millionaires overnight. In Mogul, the revised and expanded version of the 2002 game of the same name, the players will buy and sell the railway stock, trying to outsmart both opponents and the market. Each of the five railroad companies has 5 to 8 shares, and in addition to being a share of the company, each share card has a box on it that indicates another company. Players start with particular stock holding based on the number of players in the game and their position in turn order. Each turn, one stock card is revealed from a deck. The player will earn $1 for each share of the color that they own. Then an auction is used. Turn by turn, players must drop one of the bidding chips into the bowl in order to stay in the auctions. Where a player passes, whether it's necessity or choice, they take all of the chips from the bowl, thereby earning the bidding power for the future auctions. When all but one player passes, the last player auction wins the auctions and has the right to either keep the share or sell the stock of the matching color of the company depicted on the bottom of the share. The player who dropped out of the auction last takes the action that the winner didn't take. If a player sells stock, they either sell all the shares of the color they own, earning as much of each share as the number of those stocks face up on the table, or they sell none of them. In the latter case, the player plays a station depot in the color on an empty space of the appropriate color on the game board. This game board has multiple networks in 5 colors of the game, and at the game end, each depot has a dollar value equal to the number of that player depot in the same network.